And that's the real and no fancy got Vandama all the way in our studio, bringing us a performance that's beautiful to watch this morning. Jason Gazy, popularly known as Pappy Kojo, real and no fancy Vandam. Which other name do you know for him? That's the man who we have in our studio performing to us. I definitely enjoy the performance. Look, the performance is like he's chilling with himself. The last one is like he's laughing to himself.
Yeah.
And you know what he said about that? He said, whoever made the beat, if he catch him, you go beat him. But he's still to the thing. Don't mind Pappy Kojo. You know, he always finds a way to create humor. That's why he was trending on TikTok as well. So he's actually one of the musicians you see trend on TikTok. I don't know what's happened to his TikTok account in latest time, but he was definitely joined us for a conversation. So if you're ready, let's see him walk like all of them do, majestically from our studio into the studio 899, where the big conversation always happens. And of course, I'm here with all the co-hosts. Myself, Olele Salvador, there's Lenny, Sister Wonderful Lenny, and of course, Jareel Cyril, also in the building. And we are waiting to receive
the man
of the moment. The man of the moment, the man of the moment, the man of the moment, Fancy Van Damme, you know, Ray Lano. Which of the names do you love?
Ray Lano.
Okay, let's welcome Ray Lano. See him walking. Hey, you didn't come for me, star.
Hey, Pappy.
Oh, no. Charlie, this, hey, the stars, Van Damme, they come.
Van Damme is coming.
Oh.
No, but sincerely,
he was punching the camera.
The cameras have gone off.
Straight to the top, to Mayweather.
No, maybe he has some liking for Mayweather. We never know. The way he just ignored all the names I mentioned.
Oh, yeah, he's rich.
Oh, you love money.
If I'm going to beat someone, I should beat them for their money.
If they'll
punch your face for free, I'll go and beat a rich guy.
So the beat maker where you won't beat him, no?
Oh, no, that one, because he make my beat a support. That's something. So make
No, but I love the way you are enjoying yourself whilst you're performing that song. It's more like I'm laughing at myself, you know. I'm enjoying the performance. They are support me too. I'm dancing some, you know. But beautiful performance by all standards.
Thank you.
You know. Thank you. All your songs, you know, people always love the vibe that you bring.
Thank you.
It's almost like I said, you're chilling with your own self, singing your own thing, whether you like it or not. This is my song.
This is what I'm giving you.
Tell me, it's your first time performing here.
Yeah.
How does it feel like?
I'm excited, Charlie. I'm happy to be here. I always see you guys on social media.
Yeah,
I always
yeah.
wanted to come, so... Yeah.
Oh, welcome.
Oh. Why is everybody quiet?
You be American.
He had a question for you.
I don't know why you say shut well, eh?
Oh yeah, respond.
You're on your medication. So I know, like, you don't like taking pills.
I was like, oh, so this morning we have your shout to well, eh?
Is this what they say?
Oh, you don't know what they do your face.
I just shout well.
Oh, like everybody. Challenge you guys talk, eh?
No, I mean, it's great to see him, man. It's been, like I was saying earlier on Trending Live, we haven't seen you in a minute, brother.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't seen you in a minute.
For real?
Yeah, we haven't seen you in a minute.
Like, you don't live here with us.
Like, I know the last time you said Italy, how and I'm better now.
See, the honest truth be saying, me a dada ba.
Yeah!
Let them know. Let them know.
Like, I'm not even bluffing. It's like, my father is white.
Okay.
You know, like in the morning, he'll give me milk. I see if I'm all right.
Fresh milk.
Clarify,
fresh milk.
It's going to be a long
time. Ah.
It's going to be a long conversation.
Look at the way Lenny's looking at him.
I'm just wondering. I was going to ask, your father is white, but we don't even see, like.
No, it's on the inside. You don't see that I'm mixed.
It's on the inside.
Do I look like him?
No,
do I look like cereal?
No.
Do I look Ghanaian to you?
When you say look, what sense? Like I'm your skin color?
Okay. Yeah, you are. Yes, we can see it. That's very half-caste.
The cast is inside.
No, I'm sure everybody's excited to see. Like he said, we haven't seen you for a minute. I keep seeing you at airports. You know, the last returning. I think when I was returning from Nigeria last year, December, he was returning from Italy. I guess. I just assumed that that's where you were returning from. We're all waiting to get our COVID results. Man, make hot. Pappy Kojo did the airport do like this. I guess say, hey, hello, Pappy. Then he doesn't say, because at that time, you don't know whether you're going to be allowed into the country. So I think that's what everybody was going through. Recently, when I went, you didn't believe I was in Tad. I met him at the Tad.
But if somebody you want witness this guy.
You see,
unless I see Papi in my eye, nothing out here.
The people that came for Papi, you know, Charlie, superstar level, Charlie, they came in their numbers. By the time he came out from the terminal,
it's pressure.
Takoradi is my own.
I think he's a prince. He's a prince of Takoradi.
Shareholder.
Don't talk to me well when you come to Takoradi. Things will be
So you are not Ghanaian. You're not from Ghana, but you're from Takoradi.
Because my grandmother is from Takoradi.
But he said he's half-caste, so maybe he could be right. Yeah,
my mother's side.
Okay.
Yeah, from Takoradi.
So how long did you live in Takoradi for?
For 10 years.
You school there and everything.
Yeah, I was there when I was 4 until 14.
Where was mommy and daddy at the time?
Italy.
Italy. Yeah. Okay. Let's understand this. You were born in Italy,
mm-hmm.
and then you were shipped to Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
To stay in Takoradi for 10 years.
These are my friends. For 10 years.
Did it make it better or made it worse?
I loved it. I feel like everything I know now is because I grew up
in Takoradi.
If it's everything you know now, you want to share that experience with us. You know, sometimes when they say go grow with your grandma, you know, you feel like, I love it because I feel like you'll be spoiled. That's the part I love. You won't be allowed to do anything. But if you tell us everything you know now, what do you know now that you learned from grandma?
Music. From Takoradi.
From Takoradi, sorry.
Music, of course. The rap, like TV stations, the shows on TV stations, everything, things that I was raised on, you know, they're all from Takoradi.
When you go back, how does it feel every time you're back? Like you said, that's your place, but definitely when you get to a place, there's some nostalgia that comes with it.
Every time I go to Ridge International, like my school, every time I go there, like I feel breakdown. It's so powerful. It's so powerful. Like so much memories there.
What good did you
memories,
do there? Uh-huh.
Great memories.
Mm.
Great memories. If then tell me, say like, if God says, which I'm asking right tonight, I could go back and live like 10 minutes in GSS, I would do that.
What was so fun about
it? Yeah.
Life was so like this.
What does that mean?
Like, it was just free care, like free nothing, you know.
Adulting is different.
Like, fooling. Like, rap was rap. It wasn't. Bro, the competition, the messing, everything was genuine. I don't know, Charlie. It was just different in Takoradi. I did that.
Wow.
Are you saying that times have changed since then?
Yeah, I think so. I believe so.
Is it with adulthood or what has changed?
I don't know. So you know how people in Ghana, they be like, they talk about like their SS the most. They be like, SS, me, I went to like, I didn't go to SS yet. So my memory still is JSS. Right. So even my friends that I grew up with, most of them, they be like, SS, you should have been to SS. SS life was better, blah, blah, blah. Me, I know going, like the JSS is still up there. Yeah. You know? I guess if I was here, like I also be talking some like the SS lifestyle.
So where are your mates from JS? Have you met some of them as you guys have grown? And are you guys like proud of each other, what you've done?
Yeah. We have this WhatsApp group, international WhatsApp group.
You be the comedian for the group inside.
Oh no, I'll flex them for that.
You know, like me, I love the comic side of you as well, you know. Even though a bit of it reflects in your music, I just feel like you're a character that we've not, you know, truly, whether unearthed or discovered or unfolded.
Explored,
maybe that's the better word to say. Actually, with the things I...
You want to explore me? Hey! You go get beef with Stormzy.
No, I don't want to explore you, but your talent. He's still exploring him anyway.
Just last 2 days ago, we see a Stormzy.
You want to explore me?
Yeah. But what are you thinking? That she wants to explore.
So if
you.
I look at you and say, hey, I want to explore you.
You see what you're saying? That's not the tone. No, that's wrong.
That's wrong.
That, no, that is wrong.
Hey.
I want to explore you.
Now I'm rapist vibes.
You know, like, I feel like you should do more acting. I don't know where that has ended, but when we see you, especially when you were really active, what happened to your TikTok account anyway?
They keep deleting my...
Because
even, like, I'd be showing stuff. Last time I was smoking on TikTok, and they don't accept that. The other time I showed, what's this guy? Pope Skinny's pubic hair. They blocked me off, right? So...
I see why you like JSS.
So then you know.
I see why you like JSS.
At least he knows what he keeps doing wrong. He keeps doing it.
Why do you enjoy showing such on TikTok?
Why is the person showing it? Am I the one showing it?
Oh, so he showed it and then you re-showed it.
I'm just
amplifying.
He's
amplifying it. Wow.
But I so you're not back on?
Yeah, I have a new one now.
So what are you showing this time around?
Oh, this one, I'm being a good
one. This one's legal.
I don't want to lose it. It's hard to get the photo.
Yeah.
So this trip, I've stopped fooling on TikTok.
What about the acting career?
Maybe I should talk to Dumelo. I don't know.
Because I know, I think I saw you.
I think you did something back.
Yeah, that was back then with Yvonne Nelson.
So
but that's a long time ago. That was like a cameo.
You didn't enjoy it. You don't think you want to pursue?
I would love to do something, but it has to be like comedy. You know, I like to laugh. So maybe Jeko, Kojo Nkansa, Kwekumenu, Ebeke, you know? Yeah, those people.
Let me put you in
a... So if they call you for a Kumawood, give you a Kumawood script...
Yeah, I'll do it.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I love Kumawood movies. I prefer Kumawood movies to their...
Gallywood.
Yeah, the Gallywood. Everybody
does. It's not Black Star Films.
So that's
what we call it now. We call it Gallywood, though.
It rebranded.
But that's that film. The Kumawood is not part of it. That's what we
I mean, you know, Kumawood and Gallywood had that kind of segregation. Kumawood was for the Jacko.
So now we want to segregate it. That's what we are trying to do.
Yes.
I don't want to talk about all of them in general. We'll put them to Black
Star.
Because the way you're talking about comedy, I'm thinking, so why haven't you, you know, jumped into that space, you know, beyond just what you do on TikTok, like do a stand-up, maybe be featured on tomorrow at this evening, Obi is doing his Ghanaian bike card. Maybe get a feature on. You haven't tried to, you know, tell them that you I'm good enough for this.
Honestly, I would love to do it, but the thing to be said, because I'm that the buy and I really don't go out, I have a swimming pool in my house. I don't really know people like that. So maybe you can put me on.
Oh, like, dear God.
The last time the movie I did was because I was still friends with Yvonne Nelson, but right now with the beef, so I won't call her. So apart from that, I mean, if I know someone who is like interested in wanting,
why are you beefing with Yvonne Nelson? What did you do to?
It's in the past. Right now, I want to be a better guy, but you brought it up.
No,
I'm telling you my story. It's my story. I can't run away from my story.
Okay.
Do you want the truth or not?
We want the truth.
Okay,
so we want to know the story behind the truth.
It's in the past.
I think you're far away from your microphone.
the past is not the present. See, I must say that this conversation will be one of the most interesting ones because knowing Pappy, I've had an opportunity of having a conversation with him on Spaces, and I don't know.
Spaces, man. That's my new thing.
Yeah, and so having to see him do this like in person. It's like I'm just like, bro. When does it end? When does it stop?
I love Spaces. That's my new love now. I need to get away from it because it's very addictive, bro. But I love Spaces.
But is comedy an outlet for you? Is that how you survive and, you know, keep your head straight? Is that what you do to, you know, stay grounded?
It just feels good to laugh. Don't you like to laugh?
I do.
There's no reason. It's just good to laugh.
You know, let me use, even though he says your past, I just remembered something. This one, when I was doing the intro, I don't know how many of you heard me say that he says he's friends with Yvonne Nelson. He's telling us that the truth is that he's actually was friends with Yvonne Nelson, and that's why he took the script. But you know,
I'm friends to Yvonne Pelson too. And Yvonne Belson.
Y'all need to praise yourselves, man.
Bro, you lied to me this morning. You come, I ask you, say you take your pills. You say you take half.
I take half.
Bobby, let's talk about your
journey. He didn't answer the question.
He's not going to.
Bro, I get plenty girls.
Plenty Yvonne's. Yeah,
that's a Yvonne's.
Bro, that'd be problem. Asians, bro, like, come on.
So the reason I'm asking is how close those names are and how you said that you picked the script at that time because you're friends with him. I'm just wondering if she calls you again and says, look, people like your role in whatever script I give you and come play another one. Now that you're saying that you're not friends with her, it's business.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Okay.
But it has to be like, it has to be comedy, you know. It has to like be like I said, Kumawood, you know. I don't think Yvonne Nelson does comedy movies.
But you can bring in your character in there.
Nah, it has to be like a comedy movie.
But would you produce your own sitcom or perhaps your...
I would love to do that.
Yeah.
I think I can do that.
Have you attempted to do that before?
I think I know what's funny. I think I know what's funny and what's not funny. So, yeah, I think I can do that.
So what's stopping you from attempting to do that if indeed that's your... Or you want to focus on the music for now?
I'm doing both, you know. I'm doing music, I'm just having fun, but it's social media. They've given it to us. You have the TikToks, you have the reels. Like, why not use it?
Let's talk about growing up in Takoradi. I know you mentioned that in school, being in the JSS and whatnot brought a lot of memories. But would you say music started for you in Takoradi or after you left Ghana, you realized that maybe I should go back?
No. Really... In Takoradi. Everything in Takoradi. I remember very well. It was... My driver back then, that would take me to school. You say, I'll be that ambassador, the driver will come in. Yeah. So, and you always be playing Reggie Rockstone. So that's how I fell in love with rap music. So I knew Reggie, like every Reggie Rockstone song on Maka, every song. Like I know it from me. So sometimes I just call him and I'll rap it for him and then hang up.
Hey.
I don't play with my hip life.
Wow.
So,
but how does Reggie feel?
Reggie, you know, saying, boy, you said,
firstborn.
Yeah, I mean, you firstborn. Why would you call and check up on me?
You firstborn.
Like, if there's going to be a movie of Reggie Rockstone,
you'll be the producer.
You should be the Reggie Rockstone,
the junior. I think right now, too, are they grow? So it's like, then Reggie Rockstone should play himself because I really agree. I would love to play Reggie Rockstone because I feel like I really know that guy's catalog, you know. And after that, it was Obrafour.
You can't play Obrafour.
Not maybe because of his looks. That's what he's thinking.
No. I can't. I'm talking about the music, like the story. Okay, yeah. The guy one time came and it was like, oh, this new guy. His name is Obrafour. His beat is not chine 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 like Reggie Rockstone. His voice is boom boom boom. You know, it's like American one. I was like, okay. So after that, and then it was seriously after Obrafour, I was like, okay, this is what I want to do. After I heard that music and then I saw Yanum on TV, it's like, nah, I'm sold. This is what I want to do for life.
But how long did it take you from that time to materialize this dream?
That was 99.
So how long, from 99 to when did you finally say, this is the dream, this is Pappy Kojo?
99 was when I knew.
Did the dream materialize? When did we begin to see you? How long did it take for you to now start hitting studios, for you to now make music commercially?
I remember my first demo, I was in class 5. That would be like 2001, something like that. Yeah, that time then, I remember this, the hit song back then was Aife Noche. Noche, I remember, because when I went to the studio, they were playing
David,
that song.
David.
So you rapped on that?
No. I won't bring your mind to the era.
That was in class 5.
Yeah. So, I started recording in studios and... So I already knew this is what I wanted to do. So I'll go to studio and I'll battle people and then school performances and those things. I would fight for them.
So you were a battle rapper when you started?
Oh, yeah. Because I watched 8 Mile Eminem too, so I wanted
Do you remember your first rap verse?
I have the demo. I still have it, but I don't...
For real?
Yeah.
Wow.
But
I remember the chorus. Okay. And it was in Chi, because back then everyone was rapping in Chi.
Take us back to that day. What was the chorus like?
You want the chorus?
I want to hear it.
I feel like we are going to hear something.
Oh, no, it was actually a nice chorus. Odo wuna mimpe nasusubani dienye be yankase sa odo wuna mimpe nasusubani dienye be yankase sa o sisa.
This was in class 5.
This class 5.
But this is not bad at all. Yeah, at all. Why you not Flipam, man?
Lizam is my demo.
No, why you not Flipam now? Make me jump now.
I'm flying now. I'm a hitman.
No, because it sounds like it's a record.
I just see the pharmacy, they lie you. Like, if I take all the
I take half.
The half, they lie you.
But what about that song that you feel like at this point you cannot release? Because the chorus is great.
That's Kenata style.
Okay.
Okay.
Singing.
Sing rap. Yeah.
Come on. We will be guy, yo. Shamani belts, like, you know. We do rap.
Miss G, your joy is on the floor. Take your time, Miss G.
I don't know what to say again.
No, when you say
that. Production, we need shovel to pick that, Lenny's mouth from Kenata the floor.
Kenata style, right? What were you rapping about then? Because clearly you were rapping about love,
yeah,
you know,
but
women.
Like I said, it was hip life back then. Everyone was rapping in Chi and about women. Like, you know, come on. So,
but hip life is still hot. So why would you want
to? Yeah, my new song, I think, is kind of like it has a hip life flavor to it.
Yeah. Or you think you've matured over the time. And so,
I have.
Like Sak would say, you know, I think Sak and Ifia actually had that same conversation about people shouldn't judge them on songs that they had released in the past, because obviously they have matured over time.
Yeah.
Is that what you are experiencing?
Even Real Ano, I don't, honestly speaking, I don't even like performing Real Ano.
Why?
Because the rap, you know, they be me. Like, it's like I've evolved so much. Like, rapping is like,
if I knew what
things that they do, like, I could have done this, and, you know, so.
But mentioning evolution, singing about love at 5, right? How has that evolved for you? How have you gone through the years?
I knew, like, kindergarten, you know, I like girls.
So what does love mean to you now?
Why you freeze?
Ayeka.
I'm looking at her now.
Ayeka.
I'll find what love means to you.
Charlie! This guy is hot.
Those of you who aren't watching, you are missing.
Yeah, I'm missing though.
Hey, bro, Stomzy.
But she's crashing on Stomzy. Let them know.
Stomzy, if you full up, I'm going to burn them.
Recent. You go recent.
I know about giant girls for Ghana.
They're still looking for you for my question about what love means.
I mean,
sister, I wonder
maybe
who
I should
talk.
Swap position.
I've never seen Lenny quiet like
this. I'm sure I'll ask the question, so I'm waiting for
but they ask you for love. They say they are looking in your eye for love. So open the eye.
Look into
my eyes.
Don't worry, you don't have to see my eyes.
Yes, let's be going.
Come on.
The road is that.
Can we continue?
Pappy is here to tell us what love means to him at this point. Yes. He says yes. She said at this point.
Nothing matters. That's the name of my new EP.
Yeah, nothing matters.
I really believe that nothing really matters.
When it comes
to
love.
I'm a nihilist. Like, love, nothing, it doesn't matter.
Poppy, that's interesting, because I know you had, that's if you still have that lady as your girlfriend.
The one he was flaunting on social media?
Yes.
Which one?
Wow. There was a white lady you...
Oh, yeah.
Are you still together?
Oh, no, I'm single now.
So is that as a result of your...
No, it's, I think the whole of last year... I was searching for something. But that was because, that's why I said spaces are very addictive. Because I started going on spaces and I started hearing some conversations and I started doing my researches and I started learning more last year when I wasn't in Ghana. So, it just made sense to me now. You know, like, bro, at the end of the day, this world and everything is just a rock in space. Like, if you expand it, we really don't matter. So,
but what mental space were you in when you were creating this Nothing Matters EP? Or what's your mental space like?
This it has nothing to do with it. I just I had already released Logos Hope.
Yes.
This year.
Mm-hmm.
So it had been a while, and it only made sense to release another one before Bronya.
What are the genres on what's the mix on it?
Rap and hip live, and I'm a piano.
Yeah.
I think I saw
Larusso is on the,
I saw a snippet.
Caucus,
yeah.
I saw a snippet you put on your Twitter.
Yeah.
But you were actually responding to Wizkid.
No, because
in your caption you were telling us to send a message to Wizkid.
Because he said Ghanaian rapper.
No, he didn't say Ghanaian rapper.
He didn't talk about us. So
he actually big us up. He gave us two. He actually gave us two.
He said Nigerians don't get rappers.
He said Nigerians don't get rappers.
He said
two things.
He
said rap die.
Yeah.
Before he went to his people.
Yeah.
He said two things. He said rap die, full stop.
Yeah.
And he said even his Nigerian rappers who they say they be rap crown or nothing for them.
Yeah.
Because he give them opportunities of this, that, that.
Yeah. But how rap die?
Rap die, they affect everybody.
They must swim pulling.
But he said the only rappers he know be Nasty C, Sarkodie, and Lasher.
So me and Pano. No, wait, so Whiskey wants to talk about it. So EL is Pano. Manifest is Pano. That's what he's saying. T-Flow is Pano.
No, are you
upset? Kojo Q is Pano.
No. Maybe he doesn't know.
T-Real is Pano.
Maybe he doesn't know, guys.
Amanda, I deal with him.
Maybe
he doesn't know. Maybe he just mentioned. Abby is coming to
Accra. He's already here, bro. He'll come and meet me here. He make like he say no go to Accra.
No, but maybe he's just mentioning the people he's familiar knows, with, exactly, which is okay.
But if I also say I'm not familiar with Wizkid, so Afrobeat is dead.
No, I'm not saying that's why he said the rap is dead. I'm saying he's just mentioning rappers that he is familiar with.
He's not familiar with MI who discovered him.
No, maybe, they have some beef or something. Do you understand?
But did you watch MI's rant? You see MI's rant?
No, I don't.
MI will go off on him.
But Wizkid's name is even from Wheezy, and Wheezy is a rapper.
Yeah.
So if it wasn't for rapper self, we won't get Wizkid, I guess.
No, I beg to differ.
Maybe Wheezy came before Wizkid came.
But I think it was coming from a place where the kid that's basically a wizard.
So the Wiz, you know one time you say Wheezy influence, no danger.
That's for me, I don't know about people.
Then times so we all Wheezy. My name was Tef for Wheezy.
Hey.
Yeah, I swear on God.
What's Wheezy?
When I started rapping, Tef for Wheezy.
Mm. What does that mean?
So I liked Obrafour so much, so I wanted to have the four. And Tef4 means in Takoradi, okay, the etayada, you take too much of it. So Tef4 Wheezy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was he influenced from Obrafour.
Yeah. Tef4.
You don't had opportunity to do a song with any of your...
He doesn't want to do it.
Oh.
What happened?
Talk to us about it. What happened?
I think he's now a criff.
Who?
You know, Obrafour.
Really?
Yeah, so, and I believe maybe my lyrics, my...
Is that what your you style. Think, or that's what he told
I
you?
Believe.
Okay, all right.
That's what I believe.
Okay.
Speaking about the project.
No, but
right?
Wait. Let's explore that a little. Like, how long ago did you reach out? Who did you
Since
reach
I
out
came, when
directly
came
to
out,
him, to him or Obrafour or through his team?
I've been sucking Obrafour's. Yeah. I've been on Obrafour's.
Look how I opened my mouth.
I've loved Obrafour since 1999. I had his address. I used to send him letters.
Wow.
When I moved to Italy when I was 14, I used to call Obrafour from Italy because I would get the number, some number at the cassette, at the back of the cassette. And
the distribution.
I spoke to T-Blaze or find the numbers and actually call them. So Obrafour, they have been chasing him from TTT. So as soon as I blew, the first artist I wanted to work with was Obrafour.
And what was the direct message? I want to know the feedback. Forget what you think.
I'll send a song and then they will listen, you know, and then I just know that he loves me. He does. He really does. He loves me. But I just know that he knows, say, the things that I talk for music inside. If you allow me, I will talk something where you go make, I don't know, that's the vibe.
Why aren't you tailoring the song to suit the brand of Obrafour?
Because I know we're featuring myself on Obrafour.
No, but this is somebody you've idolized. No, this is somebody you've idolized. I mean,
Ricky, come and get Pappy Kojo.
Hold on, guys. This is somebody you've idolized.
Let me say, I idolize you, so you go sam me like that. It's like a pool for my house.
Go do again.
You get what for house?
Charlie, swimming pool for my house. Yeah, Mizzy, can I ask my question?
Hey, Holy Spirit. Charlie, bro. Looking at the artwork for the Nothing Matters, right? There's an astronaut sitting on some planet out in the middle of nowhere. I want to know your take on the world. Like you're saying, nothing matters. So spirituality, religion,
nothing,
everything.
Bro, nothing.
I want. So what do you believe in, apart from nothing matters?
I believe that we live in a space where we only know 3% of where we live. Like upon the galaxies and everything that we know is just 3% of what we live in. Just 3%, babe. Mm. So if you think this earth that you live on, that you have feelings and you get upset, and bro, it really, really doesn't matter. Like even if you're flying from a plane and then you're leaving, you can literally see Morocco like this. So imagine going all the way outside. Like you don't matter. I don't even think if there is anything out there, they even notice us. We don't matter.
Because the 97%,
we don't even know what it is. Like even the sea in Pwanunumpu, we haven't discovered over 70% of what's in the sea.
Mm.
You know, so...
Are these your own facts or they are...
These are facts.
These are facts.
Facts.
Yeah.
Oh, scientists say we are living on the only 3%
of... We've only 6% of the ocean.
Oh.
We've not been to the deepest part of the ocean yet.
Like, these are facts.
And we live in 3%?
Yeah, of the universe,
the galaxies. The galaxy and everything. We just know 3% of it.
Oh, so, I
see. So, I know you mentioned that space has led to some of these research findings and discoveries, right? But there must have been something that perhaps triggered, you know, you to, because this information definitely is science, and people have known this for time. I'm sure you know a bit of it. But at what point would you say, you know what, it is what it is. This is where I'm going to stand. Nothing's going to stop me.
Yeah, it just makes sense to me, bro.
I'm asking this because, you know, Eleni asked you about your
state of mind.
Your state of mind and also your past relationship, right? Mm-hmm. And right after that, we are seeing this Pappy Kojo, right? So help us bridge the gap. Is it that while she were with your lady, you started reading and all those things, or was after the breakup that led to you having time for yourself to research and then go like, you know what, nothing matters?
I don't know. It just landed me there, bro. I was very active that time because I had released Koobi. So I was really active on social media. And I just hopped on one space and they were talking about religion, spirituality and stuff. And it grew from there.
It made you curious.
Yeah, like I'm really curious about those things. Like, and so I really want to know the truth. So,
yeah. If you say, what are you saying? Like how?
Like spirituality and religion and all those things.
It's controlling.
Yeah, it's like...
So before, were you a Christian, Muslim?
I mean, I grew up with my grandma. She's a Catholic, so
okay.
I
went to Anglican. Okay, right.
After I left her, you know, and I went back to 81, like a teenage, you know? And I even had questions when I was living with her. Like, even with the Bible, I would ask her, who wrote the Bible? Where does it come from, you know? I remember very well, but... She would always say, just read it, just, you know, so, I just wanted to find out, research,
What are some of the things you've had to do on your self-discovery journey, you know, things that you've had to draw, pick up along the line, add up to what you know, and then all of that, just to shape, yourself?
I would say travel. I feel like if you travel and you see different cultures, you meet different people, you engage with different people, you understand the world more. I feel like growing up like this, me, I used to hate gay people when I was young because I'm a Catholic. So I'm gay and I'm a boy. But like growing up, it's like, you know, you learn more, you understand life more, you know, so... I'm just still learning, bro. I just want to learn, you know? Yeah.
You know, there was a time where people actually called one.
People believed, because more effect. That's the only reason. Like, that's the only reason. Like, no guy will come and say, I slept with my Pappy Kojo. Like, the way I was.
But now was also, you're actually enabling the conversation. I remember, during the COVID time, Pappy was quite bored.
Yeah.
So every conversation he had, he would just find a way to, you know, enable certain things and make you believe that. So maybe you also give people the impression.
It was
the swimming pool. Nice.
Cyril can't even stop laughing.
It was the swimming pool.
I'm just a good-looking guy. So you would think I'm gay.
Talk your ish, bro.
Wait, no, So wait, is that to say every good-looking guy, every handsome guy, every guy that dresses nice is said to be gay? Is that what you're saying?
No, is that what you are saying? Or that's what society says.
That's what society like. Bro, all I know is that I'm fly, so you would think I'm gay. That's it.
Let's go to the artwork of your EP. Nothing Matters. You know, I just saw track 3, and I got excited.
I saw it too.
Anybody, can we project that on the screen? Let them see it.
Who was the other person saying you're going to farm it?
We don't stop. It's not like we don't stop. Oh. Yeah. It's we don't stop. What does that mean? Like we, like weed.
Yeah,
Jay. And then type thing. Yeah, bless up. Charlie, give me.
And you left it in like that.
I was waiting for this question.
Oh, yeah, I know.
She thinks
I see the album and I was like, oh.
They will ask this question, so I don't have the answer for them.
Okay, so.
You forsake the designer. That type of.
So you allow the designer to put you in this light.
It was a mistake and I was in a hurry. I had to upload it.
But there's no part when you drop the caption that you said, oh, Charlie, number track 3.
I don't know why you are forcing it. I feel like you're pushing me right now. I've given you the answer already. Please, let's move on to the next
one. We should move on to the next one. The next one will excite you. You know, Nothing Matters. When you're talking, you say, oh, Charlie, you are war feelings. Oh, and you say, you bore and all of that. If there's anybody that I know that has feelings past you, that can bore at any moment and rant at any moment in this space, I'm yet to find them. You know, like, Pappy can just wake up one day, it's like, I'm coming for you, Lenny.
Yeah.
Lenny, and you did this, you went here, you went there. Like, and now he's telling me that nothing matters. You know, there must have been something happening.
No, that's what you need to know. Like, if I say it on here.
But why do you say it then? Because you went off on Joey B. You went off on, what's
and
his
what
name?
And what happened?
The guy from Nigeria.
We don't even know his name.
What's his name?
We don't even know
what's Empower's name?
We don't even know
his name. Mr. Eazi. You went off on Mr. Eazi. You went off on a lot of people on social media. And these are things that...
Those times he didn't take the half pill.
Those are things that people can easily Google and pick up. Even now that you're saying it doesn't matter, it matters on the internet.
Yeah.
What happened?
But I said the truth. I didn't lie.
What happened?
You still haven't been paid by that record?
Nothing still. And I'm looking for a lawyer. People think I'm joking. Like, I am.
What was the arrangement? What was the agreement? What was the contract like?
Nothing has been... I don't want to come and say stuff. Yeah, I don't want to...
Yeah, but you say you want to say the truth.
I don't want to... Some things are personal and I might say it and, you know, but...
But I want to start here.
Yeah, because...
Yeah, you haven't been paid.
Truth. Maybe it's truth matters.
Do you know if Atapa has been paid? Do you know if Atapa has been paid or you're the only one out of the park?
I don't care about Atapa's pocket. I care about mine.
No, let's go back to the making of Akwaba. What was the deal?
Even
what
want
happened?
To talk about Akwaba.
Because
I
that's
honestly,
where the conversation started from.
I feel like I've said what I have to say about Akwaba. That's it. You know, all I'm looking for is a good lawyer. I mean, the right here. If you put the watch, I need a good lawyer. Mm. That's it, guys. I'm not going to make anybody come and disrespect me, especially someone not living in Ghana who can disrespect me in my own land, Ghana. No.
But how are you still looking for a lawyer several months after? Because, I mean, to me, I think maybe by this time you should have found one if you're truly looking.
But I am. Like okay. If anyone would help me, I am.
There are too many lawyers in town. Well, how come you're still looking for? Like, you have not gone to any...
I spoke to one, like, almost... 2 weeks ago, he hasn't gotten back yet. So, but I really like.
For the benefit of those who are perhaps going to hear the story
for the first time,
just give us, you know, just a glimpse of what really the Akwaba situation is.
Or what you say you're in the
right
for.
So perhaps a lawyer.
You're not going back to the story, but you say you're in the right. I want to go to court because
let me be very honest. Mm-hmm. You know, I've grown and I've matured and I understand people to go through their own personal stuff. So at the end of the day, me and Guilty Beat had a relationship.
Mm.
So I'm going to respect that and not even go or say anything.
You don't want to mind.
You understand? Mm. But he knows what's real. The other people to know what's real. That's it, Charlie. Like the name Akwaba Sef is from my mouth. You understand? Mm. So like,
you know, Papi, I know we have been educated on how artists make their money on streaming platforms and whatnot, right? So when you say you want your money or you want your cut, what was the agreement? Was the agreement a one-off thing or per the streams you are getting?
It's not about that. It's the disrespect.
Oh, like, okay.
They had like a remix of the song, some Trinidad remix somewhere there.
You were not consulted.
And my vocals are there, the hook and everything is there, no credits, no nothing.
So that's where the problem is.
So it's like, even if you're like, don't disrespect me too, like, nobody be kidding for you. Like, do the right thing. You run a company, do the right thing.
So that means the issue is not even about the Akwaba record.
It's all fact of that, it, like P, Bebre, like all of it is plenty, you know. And you act like you don't know what's going on. But
how long are you gonna go for on this fight? Because you said nothing matters. Are you willing to let it go?
Nothing really matters. At the end of the day, Charlie, I guess swimming pool. Like, my father is wise. I can. What I want them to understand is that I didn't come to Ghana to do music, to fly to outside and then be happy that music took me outside. I didn't do music to buy my mom a house. I didn't do music to buy myself a house. This is what I love to do. I do it because I love Reggie Rockstone. I love Obrafour. I know my hip life. This is my life. That's it. Even if I don't get nothing from it, I'm sure I'll still be rapping because this is my life.
So you are looking at a hobbyist,
like, this is my music life. Professional. Like, this is my life.
Pappy, I'll come back after we read some set of LPM. So let you actually use this to enlighten those who might go through the same rudiments. You know, we've had conversations weeks after weeks where people come in and say, oh, I did it because of friendship. I did it and I didn't know at that time. And that happened. And we didn't have any contractual binding and all of that. We'll come back to you to use this, maybe what you've learned to maybe educate or enlighten somebody listening that, look, before this, don't say this person, Lenny is my friend. So Lenny say, hop into studio, do this. And maybe what you've learned afterwards, and maybe just impact people there. So Papa, get your BNO ready. You also get your whiskey ready. What do you have? You have Milo. Okay.
The Milo so, man with his mineral.
So get your whiskey ready whilst I do Milo. Oh, you have Milo?
Yeah.
Okay, so go ahead.
If you can decide, let me do my
BNO. Are you ready with your BNO?
First things first. Premium water.
Go ahead with your BNO.
Discover a world of innovation, a world of luxury, and a world many of us dream about owning. Discover the world of Bang & Olufsen, the particularly true brand in the ever-evolving realm of high-end electronics you might love to own. Locate us at our showroom here in Accra, Atlantic Tower Liberation Road 1. Each passing day, month, and year, varieties of drool-worthy new electronic gadgets ranging from exquisite home theaters, speakers, headphones, television sets, and soundbar products are available and released for your purchase. Bang & Olufsen, like no one else. Over to you.
All right, Milo, do you have it or I should go ahead?
I don't, please go ahead.
Are you ready to wake up the champion in your child today? That's right. You know, don't just wake up your child. Wake up the champion in them with energy from Milo with Active Go and other foods. Your child needs all the help they can get as they go through their daily activities. Milo with Active Go contains natural goodness of malt, milk, cocoa, and is a source of vitamins as vitamin B, B2, B3, B6. B12, C and D, and minerals such as iron, calcium, phosphorus. Energize them with a nourishing cup of Milo every day. Milo, the energy to go. And this advert is approved by FDA.
Vetted and approved.
Okay. Who has whiz? You have done a lot of whiz today. Yeah, do you have whiz with you?
Yes. Go ahead with your whiz. I do. Okay, so it's happening tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Live Hub Entertainment, Wizkid Live. It's happening at the Accra Sports Stadium. And so if you haven't gotten your tickets yet, thankfully, you can still get it via short code STAR 920 star 60 star 10 hash. That's star 920 star 60 star 10 hash. Or you can also log on to www.wizkidlive.happening. That's HAPNIIN.com, and then get your tickets as well. And I think this is one concert that's going to set the tone for all of the other concerts that are going to happen this December. So yes, I mean, just come out, come have some December fun because it's going to be crazy. They also have some outlets at the Accra Mall as well. So yes, you can grab your tickets from there as well.
Are you having a concert this December? Normally, I see you go back to Tadi to do some stuff. Are you doing that this year?
No.
What happened?
I wanted to have like my own concert, but I don't think I'm ready.
The ones you've done previously are not yours?
Yeah, they are, but the way I wanted to do it this time, like...
the masquerade.
Charlie, it's bigger than, you know, it's bigger than that.
Is it budgets?
Everything, some, you know, plus, you know, Kenyatta has a show, Takoradi, Made in Tali.
Made in Tali, mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, I don't want to, like, also do it in December, because his is happening. So I'm thinking of rather doing it, like, Easter, maybe. Mm. You know, so yeah, that's the plan.
Has there been any previous clash, because you've had it in December prior to now, and he's also had it in December?
Oh no.
There's no been. So no. What became the change of, you know, why is this new suggestion that, okay, let me change my date or move it to? Is there anything that's the reason?
Yeah, I feel like because when it's a show, I would love to play, and when it's mine too, you'll have to play mine. So it only makes sense.
The reason I'm asking is that prior to now, there's been this conversation, like my producer was whispering in my ear earlier when you were talking about Kenyatta, that back then when he was in Tadi, it was like a big deal. It looks like the fans had created some beef between you and Kenyatta.
Yeah.
And so it was running for a very long time.
Oh, yeah. Hey.
Oh, Cyril, please help me. I'm sorry, but you know, it is a reaction that his reaction got me. The way he said it was going down, you know.
This is just a quick one. Made in Tadi has been cancelled for the year.
I saw that press release yesterday.
Made in Tadi,
it's been cancelled. Kenyatta.
Yes, it's cancelled for the year.
No reason.
He said he's been booked on a number of shows, so he wouldn't be able
logistics.
To.
Logistics.
Yeah. They want to prepare better and come back next year. But he hasn't answered the question about, you know, the seeming beef that has been hanging on your heads in Takoradi for a very long time. Have they come to accept, you know?
Oh, yeah, I think right now they get it. It's just Ghana things. Like, if new artist comes, they put this one against that one. So it's just normal. Like,
did it affect your relationship for a very long time?
Never.
Because I think there was a time that I heard that you were supposed to have Kofi feature on a song of yours or something like that, and it never happened or something.
But this is like a long time ago.
That's what I'm asking, whether it at any point affected the relationship had.
No, at all. Like, me and him were always good. It was just the fans in Takoradi. But that's just, it's just Takoradi thing. They like to tease, they like competition. You do not want to.
What's the rap? Sorry, please go ahead.
How is December looking?
She wants to ask me questions.
Hey,
baby, I'm sorry.
Chineke. How is December looking like for you then, in relation to your craft and your art?
Oh yeah. I just dropped a new EP this morning, so I'll be promoting that and shows here and there, and my friends too are coming from Italy, so maybe we'll be doing some. Volta North trips and stuff. So
bring your vibes. Any pool party?
That pool party is a daily thing, of course. It's day my house, Angasa. Like, just call me and come.
Guys, let's spend the next couple of minutes talking about the Nothing Matters EP.
Yeah,
I want to go into that.
I was going to ask him. The rap scene in Takoradi is like. Before you joined us, we played. A record or a music video where you featured some, you know, I don't want to say upcoming, but some great rappers in Takoradi. I think the focus was to exhibit these rappers, right? Yeah. Take us to Takoradi and take us to the rap scene in Takoradi. Now we know of Asaka as a movement, or Kamerica as a movement. In Tadi, what is it like, you know, and what should we expect since you are the prince?
They are great, great. Please, why did you call me the prince?
The president of Tadi?
The king.
I'm sorry.
Like, king of Tadi.
Nana, yes, sir.
Are they look prince to you?
We are sorry, Nana.
Talk well.
Nana.
So, I feel like there are really good rappers in Takoradi.
Mm.
Like, bro. Didn't they rap, bro? Like, there are really, really good rappers in Takoradi. Mm. That I know for sure. Mm. Like, if you can get someone to rap some good fancy bars, like, you'll be there smiling the whole time.
Mm.
So that's what I love about Takoradi. The culture is still there. People still rap and try to impress, you know. So
what has been the challenge for that scene to break into perhaps mainstream? Because we've seen, you know,
it's mainstream in Takoradi. Like, Takoradi, they just like rap.
Yeah, but I'm saying that apart from you and perhaps, who can I even talk of? Ayesem.
just a few fancy rappers we could think of. Kwakese obviously.
There's T-Flow as well.
T-Flow is from Cape. Keche is from Takoradi.
Oh, okay. Okay, so you see.
So like rappers like me, Keche. Even last minute.
You get it. So I'm looking at how they can. I know there's one. Is it Kojo Viper?
Kojo Viper.
Is it from Cape Coast or from Takoradi? I'm not too sure.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, but he's an amazing fan of rap. I've heard him rap. So what's the challenge, you know, with having to break into the scene? When I say the scene, like the means, like the way you have broken through, or what are you doing to help bring them into light?
Bro, what I can do is what I'm doing. You know, I can do it all. Sorry. That's okay. So, I mean, Charlie, I always tell them, Charlie, right now where the game is going is all social media. You know, you don't even have to depend on anyone. Mm. Just be active on your social media, give them content. They'll come to you. So, yeah, that's it. Now it depends. If you have personality, you have the character and everything to do that, yeah, then because you can't just depend on anyone right now. You have it on your phone.
What made you Pappy Kojo? Was it your
name? That's my name. Like, if I call my grandma right now, she'll say Pappy or Tiden. Like, I've always been called Pappy.
When I say what made you Pappy Kojo, I'm saying that once upon a time, there was a charge, you know, by yourself, Joey B, and a few others, and you broke into the industry with Willa, and I think you did a remix with, Sarko there?
We didn't do a remix. It was I Late.
Like, you were dropping back to back, you know. What did it for you? Was it because of your unique fancy rap? Was it because of your style? Because, you know, once upon a time, you inspired a generation of, you know, fashion enthusiasts. They were dressing like you. Mm. They were wearing the bandanas like you. They had
you, you said you did it.
I didn't wear the what do you call it, the jeans, the punchy holes.
Oh, okay,
the
jeans, that's everyone's
thing. That's okay. Yeah. So what do you think, you know, contributed to that success? Was it
like, bro, management? I feel like that thing, it really just happened. Like, it wasn't even planned.
Mm.
Like, it really wasn't planned. It just happened. So I don't even know. It wasn't planned. I wasn't coming to Ghana to become a superstar. I wasn't coming to Ghana to do music and blow. No. We just did it. We put it on Twitter. Next day, boom.
With how you've spoken about your music and then also making music just because you love it, right?
Mm-hmm.
How serious is music and music business to you? And then do you have a team you work with?
Yeah, I'm very serious with the business side now, Seth. Like, you know, I feel like the game itself has evolved. You know, like the time we came out, 2014, like even Spotify and those things weren't, I don't think they were heavy like that here in Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so
MP3 tweets.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So everything, like, it changed small. So I feel like we are adapting to it. But yeah.
So let's now go into Nothing Matters with the last number of minutes that we have. The questions, anybody who asks you anything that is Nothing Matters, don't mind the person.
Oh, let's stick to Nothing Matters. There's one important question we have
well,
to ask.
Well, when we are done exhausting Nothing Matters, then we'll come to that. So we have. I noticed that you have 4 tracks on the EP. But it looks like constantly you've been doing EP business.
Yeah, I think it's quick and it's... It's just quick. It makes sense now. You know, you don't just... Because an album needs, too much work. You know, but EPDA, like 4 or 5 songs, you're straight.
You're done.
Yeah.
So, like, this is the third in a row, right?
This is my third project. Mm. But this is my second EP.
Second EP, but third project. Let's look at the track. So, track one is intro. What is that? So, are you coming to pour some appellations or what?
Oh, you guys cannot play here. Like, it's a funny skit, but...
Oh.
You later on, then you check
then
it
we'll
out.
Then we'll check it out, eh? Yeah. Okay.
So the first one is a skit. It was someone complaining about me, calling me, said Pappy Kojo is the most senseless artist. So I think I thought it was funny.
There's someone in reality calling you that, or it's just you creating that.
Let me see. I think it's I think it's really funny. It's like me saying Michael Jackson is the most senseless artist. Like, it's just funny. You know, it's a funny statement. So. I just put it.
It
there.
Happened in reality.
Yeah.
Somebody called you that.
Yeah.
So is it with the voice or?
Yeah. The voice and everything.
They sent you a voice.
No. It was on.
I think it was on social media.
Oh, you know the person.
I think you guys know the person.
You did the same. You did the same thing for Logos.
I don't want to.
You don't want to mention the person. Oh, somebody that we
it's
know.
It's an industry person.
Yeah.
Oh, it's an industry person. Oh, okay. Okay. I didn't know about that. And so you're responding to that person.
Yeah, he said I'm a senseless artist.
Mm-hmm.
So I gave him some senseless songs.
Oh, yeah. You actually had time to give the person
nothing really matters. So
okay, yeah, that's
no, but that's the only thing on the intro.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's just it.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
We will need to check that out. And then we come to La Russo is supposed to be like a dancehall artist. So yeah. What are you featuring him in a rap song for?
That's the vibe I wanted for that song. I wanted Rasta vibe, dancehall vibe.
Mm.
And La Russo is new energy. Numujaniya show, new one, energetic, and he killed it. So
wow.
Yeah.
We're looking forward to it. And that's called Frass.
Frass.
What does that mean?
With the party, with the frass, with the high. Actually, we will tell you.
So, what does that mean?
Oh, for those of you don't party. Your network is not clear.
No, because I don't. Frass, I've never heard that.
You never hear frass before?
No.
Come on, man.
I'm serious. Oh, no, on a more serious note.
We'll tell you off air, Miss G. Let's be going.
Or like something that you can't say on air.
Yes.
Okay. But we are supposed to be singing it.
A drone.
Oh, the song's medication.
With the frass.
Medication.
So, with the party, with the frass.
With the frass.
Does that mean like, with the fra? Is that what it means?
Oh, they mean medication.
Even on Twitter, people have already started talking about the accused children on Twitter.
Oh, really? Oh,
that's what I was laughing about.
Some of the messages, let's hear.
Let me read this.
Look at them. Please zoom into the two of them.
I don't know why.
They said, wow.
Let me hear that one.
Lenny Lomote, you have said only 4 words since the interview started. Let me just put this out there in the universe. You and Pappy Kojo will be cute ASF.
At
this point, they are obsessed with Culture Daily.
Hey!
And that's from Gordon Selassie.
I think I found 28 the audio.
Minutes ago.
Yvonne, the audio.
Lenny, why are you worried?
I'm stressed.
Are you guys ready?
You know you're stressed.
This one is identify.
When we are going, then you play that one. I hear that we'll be flagged if we play it. So
no, this
you
one have to.
The man who is in charge said you won't be flagged, so I don't know.
This one, you'll be flagged for this one.
I know that voice.
Okay, so says track 3, We Don't Stop. So what's that song about? You know, We Don't Stop.
It's a party song.
Okay.
I'm a piano. I feel like I'm the best. I'm a piano artist in the world. Yeah. So it's only right I give to the universe.
Because even the people
matters.
Who brought the I'm a piano. The people who brought the I'm a piano are not, you know.
Did you hear what I said?
Yeah, you said you're the best I'm a piano artist in the world.
Yeah.
But I'm a piano comes from South Africa. And I'm asking
it doesn't matter. Nothing matters.
You don't think you're doing it best?
Nothing matters. I am the best I'm a piano artist.
Straight.
That's it.
Believe in your ish.
Straight.
And track 4, which is the last on it.
At the back,
featuring Kwakesi.
Yeah, one.
What's at the back?
One Young G and one OG.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kwakesi. Bro, I'm a big fan of Kwakesi.
Oh.
You know, if you can tell, I've worked with like people like growing up.
Yeah.
The Hammers artist, all those guys. Mm. So. And I'm working with Skonti too, and they work together. So.
Yeah. Skonti.
Mm. Looking at the
is Skonti not Kwal's brother? That's not his brother.
No.
They look alike, mom.
I thought that was his brother.
I know you're talking about.
Bro.
But you didn't tell us about what At The Back means. What's he about? Is that another party song?
You turn your head and you will see what's at the back.
At the back. Yeah. My t-shirt, what's written behind my t-shirt?
Romance.
That was at the back.
14, something.
That's what's at the back.
No.
Then that is what
you are not
is.
Looking well.
No, that's what it is. It's romance.
Oh, you see that? Is that it's romance.
Bars. Bars. The best.
Nice.
We the rapo.
Charlie.
Bro.
Yeah.
All the new crop of artists, different vibes coming up. Who's on your radar? And like you've said, you like to collaborate, mix up vibes and all that. The kiddies, chow. Who's on your radar? Because a lot of people looked up to you and then they themselves found themselves now in the industry. And I'm sure you're also listening to the scene and hearing.
You mean rappers?
Yeah, rappers, musicians, Afrobeats, whoever.
I feel like... I feel like... the rappers, bro. Okay, see real. Let's be real, okay? Cereal. Cereal. Mm-hmm. Okay, cereal. You cereal.
And a cereal.
Okay.
Real life. No.
Okay, so. Hey.
Again. You see, you're about to be you're about to laugh.
You people don't like me at all.
What button do you keep pressing?
No, have you realized
anytime? Every time he presses a button,
like every time he's about to say something untrue, then he begins to sink.
Yeah. Okay. Hey, I like the way you flip your hair.
I'm waiting. If you don't have hair, you understand.
We are sorry.
Yeah. Sorry. What was the question again? Sorry.
Oh, you said that these days rap. We were about to say something.
The kind of rap that I like, you know. I think rap has kind of like changed now. So, I don't know. I really don't know. But I feel like everybody that in style is nice. You know, like I like Mole style.
Which I Mole as in Koffi Mole.
Yeah, Mole.
Okay. Cause right now everybody is like a singer.
Really? We don't have rappers anymore.
New ones.
Not new ones that you can work with, because what you are saying means that they did, but not up to the standard you want to work with.
No. I would love to work with them. Like, the new rappers, I would love... That's not what I'm saying.
Okay.
But what I'm saying is that, like, you know that your type of rapping, can you give me a new artist now who does that?
Like
that
hardcore.
Yeah, like gangster rapping. Yeah, like...
Did you mention
talking about issues, you know?
No, he's saying he's making a point that the kind of rap that is rap...
It's watered down.
Right now, it's not on the market. You've been told you.
Yeah, so...
So you have to adapt to what is available.
Exactly, yeah.
All right,
Pappy. I don't know how you're gonna tell. I know you keep saying nothing matters. People have waited and are looking forward to see you and your brother come back, do something together. What's the latest on that on your side? Because I know you.
Which brother?
Joey B.
But I won't even entertain it.
Oh,
no,
how?
No, like we just got a message. I'm gonna read it for you.
Read it to him, maybe then you'll know that it's a message. Sometimes they think you're asking the question for you, so read it.
Yeah, but you don't need, like.
Please ask Pappy Kojo the relationship between him and Real Joy B. Where at all did they meet? We really love their bond. Are they coming back together because nothing really matters?
The tricky with
you
your own words.
You use your words, so right
the
now,
the tricky with your own words.
Fans want Pappy Kojo nil.
This one, they matter.
Yay!
This one,
they matter. Wow.
What a show.
Is that bad?
What a show.
This one.
Is it that bad?
Media, I don't want to work with him anymore.
Not even friendship?
From my side, no. I'm good.
Even if it's business? Because the last time on the speech, you said if Sarko, they
brought I'm telling you, like, I have a pool, I have a house, my mommy is good.
So do you still stand by Sarko?
I don't go to the embassy to go and get a visa. If I want to fly, I just go to the airport.
Because you're Italian.
Exactly.
I'm saying the last time on the speech, you mentioned that if Sack called both of you and say, I want to put the two of you in a record, you would do it because of Sack and you do it because of a business.
No.
But now you won't do it at all.
You don't need.
Like, nothing matters.
Ayaka.
Let me read some of the messages that we've got for you. So you've read the Gordon's one that talked about she's turning only forward. So Pappy Kojo is effortlessly
funny.
No, because Ricky's speaking in my ear. Is effortlessly funny. He can't even pretend to be serious for a minute. I'm loving the conversation this morning. It's coming from Mr. Berry. And too much fun. Prince of a Flower also saying that. And he says the fan mode guest. You are the fan mood guest that he's talking about, you know. Anybody has seen any that they want to also read out before we take Papi's last words? Before
see how Lelomote the smile give Pappy Kojo. Oh, she's in love.
Me too. I'm smiling for her. I'm also like, what are they saying? I don't even understand. What's going on? They should stop it.
Pappy.
Okay, Supremo Machala says, drip check. Top vibes to you, Pappy Kojo. The EP is good, yeah.
Thank you.
That's from Supremo Machado.
So where do we find this EP? Since people are talking about
it's everywhere. It's everywhere already. I just need to go home now and then get the video ready. So it's everywhere. Make sure you go on your Spotify, Apple Music, Audio Mac.
Which videos? Which video are you getting ready?
Frass.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's time for us to have another look at that performance that Pappy gave us when he came in. This all time will allow us. I don't know if you want to say a thing or two before we go.
Yeah, I mean, nothing matters is out. Shout out to Skonti, shout out to Kwao, shout out to LaRusso, shout out to Jake. Create the Jake with the fire artwork. Shout out to everyone, Charlie. I hope you guys love it. And video drops tonight. Thank you.
All right, video drops tonight. Make sure you catch it. We are out of here. My name is Ms. G. I've been here with Cyril, Lenny, and Olile Salvador. Our guest definitely Pappy Kojo, and we're going to see that performance once more. It takes us into the weekend. Have a great one.